We staan hier op het Eastside Blues Festival backstage. En we hebben hier bij ons Jay Demkin van de Jay Demkin Band. Die straks hier nog op het podium gaat verschijnen. We hebben een klein interview met hem. Straks gaan we nog wat beelden van hem opnemen. Die gaan we ook te zien en te horen krijgen. Maar we hebben hier Jay bij hem staan en hij heeft zijn day bij. Hi Jay, welcome here.
How's it going, man?
Doing fine, okay. Is this your first time in Holland?
No, we've come here quite a few times. Yeah. And we keep coming back, it's great.
Yeah? Okay, yeah. Must be, yeah. You're quite young for playing the blues, isn't it?
Yeah, well, you know, there's a lot of young people nowadays, so you got to keep it alive somewhere.
What happened?
Parents, influences, you know, good influences, I think. I got lucky. Yeah. I got lucky.
What was the first blues record you heard?
I think it was probably Papa Chubby.
Papa Chubby?
Yeah, when I was about 9 years old, I heard him on the Paul Jones Show, BBC Two, and and luckily got to play with him eventually, so he was basically my influence and one of my biggest idols, really.
It's a dream come true, isn't it?
It is a dream come true, it's very lucky. I don't know if it's luck, I don't know if it's anything to do with it. But yeah, I'm very happy, so.
I read in your bio, you must be a sort of a multi-instrumentalist. You're playing guitar, you're playing drums, you're playing bass, keyboards as well, what more?
Well, with music, instruments and composition and styles, I think, like I always say, you can't strictly stick to one. So I feel like you play the same thing, it's just a different engine you play it on. So I get interested in an instrument, I play it, I get the hang of it, I get something else. It's just one type of thing played on a different instrument, you know? So, and it's all music to me.
Then, playing such a lot of instruments, is it then more easy to compose songs?
I always say, and I'm a witness because I play lots of different instruments. I mean, if you play piano, you've got a better grasp of compositional skills because it's all in front of you, you know? I mean, guitar, you can tell when someone's written a song on a guitar, can't you, you know? So I'd say, yeah, it's much better for writing songs.
We got here your first album, Sorted. Recorded when?
I recorded it 2008, so it's almost 2 years ago now, in June. My niece was born the same day we were recording it, which was nice. And so we've had it quite a while now. We're still playing the songs, but we're here as a tour this month, and we're going to record some more songs for the next album, which I've been dying to do.
Yeah, because you're having a new album as well.
Yeah, that's the next big thing. So we should be recording that in the next week or so, and it's going to be good.
All your own songs?
Yes, all original. I never record a single cover. There's no need for that. There's too many songs out there already, you know. I want to write some more.
Okay. One of the things we ask sometimes, and maybe it's a stupid question for such a young kid as you are, but did you have to have misery in your life to play the blues?
Oh, trust me, that's just a rumor. It's like a Greek myth. That's not true. You get a feel for it. You get a feel for anything. You can write a sad song from a happy emotion. You can write a happy song from a sad emotion. They say writing happy songs is the hardest thing to do. So I think blues is the simplest. Obviously, it goes back from, you know, the fields and, you know, work songs and things. But really, I think it's a feeling thing, if anything. You don't have to be sad to write it. You don't have to have the misery. I say I've had heartbreak. I'm only 23. I've never had heartbreak in my life. That'd be silly, you know?
Okay. I'm looking forward to see this show. I'm looking forward to listening to your records. I'm looking forward to listen to your new record.
Yeah.
Have some fun. Have some fun on stage.
Of course, I'm really looking forward to it too. It's a lovely venue.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
The Jay Demkin Band.